हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
सी लास्ट क्लास व्हाट हैव यू डिस्कस्ड। हेलो युगंधर,
सर
युगंधर हाँ, लास्ट क्लास व्हाट हैव यू डिस्कस्ड, टेल मी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल।
वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट स्टील परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन एंड
Okay, classification of steels. Last class we have discussed about classification of steels. Yes,
yes sir.
Okay. See, can you tell classification of steels? How many number of?
Three, sir.
Classification.
Tell me. Hardened, cylindrite.
Anna,
Sir,
Yugandhar,
yes, sir.
Is it visible screen?
Visible, sir.
What? Screen ఏం కనిపిస్తుంది?
Apps కనిపిస్తుంది, sir.
Okay. Just okay, and then I will open. See, steels and cast irons, Anna. Okay, na. Steels and cast irons. Just metals alloys can be classified into two types. One is the ferrous and non-ferrous. Okay, ferrous and non-ferrous. See, ferrous we can classify into two types: steels, cast irons. Steels, cast irons. See, cast irons classification here. That is there. Next one is steels. Steels you can classify into low alloy, high alloy. Okay, low alloy steels. Here, low alloy steels you can classify into low carbon, medium carbon, high carbon. Okay. Next one is the high alloy steels. You can classify into that is the tool steels and stainless steels. Tool steels and stainless steels. Okay, na. Okay. Next, low carbon steel, na. Low carbon steels. That is the plain steels and high strength low alloy steels. Medium carbon also plain. Next heat treatable. Next high carbon is plain tool steels. See here, na. Ferrous, non-ferrous. See already we have discussed that is ferrous means it consists of iron. Non-ferrous doesn't have any iron. Okay, here ferrous alloys, particularly steels, that is maximum percentage of that is steel range is 0.05 to 2% of carbon. That is the carbon steels, low alloy steels, high alloy steels, tool steels, stainless steels, super alloys. Next one is the cast iron. In cast iron, that is carbon percentage is 2 to up to 4.5. That carbon percentage is here. Non-ferrous alloys are mainly doesn't have any iron, only pure without iron. That is metal remaining elements will present in that alloy. Okay, that is example aluminum alloy, magnesium alloy, copper alloys, titanium alloys, nickel based super alloys. These are the alloys. Nana, see here that classification also I hope you are seeing here. That is from iron carbon diagram. An iron carbon diagram, see here the percentage of carbon is there. Next one is here how the phases are changing. It's okay na, microstructures. Okay, here that is the austenite, that is the gamma phase. Here 0 to 2% is carbon. Next one is the cast iron. Sama here is steels less than 1.4% is carbon. Cast iron is that is 3 to 4% is carbon. Next one is the non-ferrous. Non-ferrous alloys are copper, aluminium, magnesium, titanium. Okay. Okay. Hello. Ma, you under?
Yes, sir.
Okay, is it visible?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay, Nana. See, carbon steels. The carbon steels, other terms are plain steels, mild steel, low carbon steels. Ma, see here available in almost all product forms. Ma, this carbon steels. See, sheet strips, bar. Bar some plates, tubes, pipes. Next, its designation is like the example that is the seen on here. 10 watt is steel. In that 0.4% is of weight of carbon. Up to 2% of carbon. This one is the carbon steels. The limitation for other alloying elements, that is the silicon. Silicon, copper, manganese. These are the percentages are given here. High strength, low alloys. Okay, na. Here one more thing is, Nana. Here that is the plain. See, plain low carbon steels. Plain low carbon steels. That is the series are there. 10, 10, 10, 20. A36 like this. That is the tensile strength, yield strength, ductility as given. The applications. Suppose just if you take that is the 10, 10. In this one, that is the tensile strength is 325. Next one is the yield strength is 180. Next one ductility is 28%. That is applications are automobile panels, nails and wires. That are the application. Then next one is the 10, 20. That is the applications. That is the mechanical properties that the applications has given here. That is remaining high strength, low alloy steels also there. Okay, here what it means? AISI. AISI means the American Iron and Steel Institute. SAE, the Society of Automotive and Engineering. ASTM, the American Society for Testing and Materials. UNS, the Uniform Numbering System. These are all our designations of steel samma. Okay, na already just here. I hope you are seeing here. That is designations of steels. Different types of steels are there. That's why the steels have designation, particular designation for identifying purpose that has been given for each and every steel. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, people are coming here. Okay. Here, one more thing is. Hey, please mute your cell phone, sir. Hello. Hello. See, mute your cell phones. Nana, you come there.
Sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is it visible, the screen? Okay. Don't visible, make any sir. Noise. See, all of you mute your cell phones. Okay. Okay. See, ILIs steels. That is the tool steels, Amma. Nana, tool steels. The tool steels are the properties, particularly the tool steels here, that is the shock resistance tool steels, that is cold work tool steels, hot work tool steels. Next one is the hello high speed tool steels, nana. That are tool steel classification. I hope you are here. All the tool steels will be used, particularly making the tool samma. Okay, tools. Particularly, I hope you have this tool steel samma. Okay, na. Next one is the here. That stainless steels and super alloys. Stainless steels and super alloys. Here cold work. That tool steels classification. Just we have seen. That is the cold work. Cold work. That means here W O A next D. Some letters are there. That is the cold work prefixes. Sama. See, that is the W means water hardening. O means oil hardening. Next one, A is the medium alloy air hardening. Okay, this hardening and all we will discuss next unit. Okay, cold work. In cold work, you see specific types are W1, W2, W5. That means W means work hardening. Amma, here O1, O2, O6, O7. Okay, that are also mentioned. Okay, next one is the shock resisting. That is the you see here. That is the S. S means that is the prefix. Yeah. S1, S2, S4, S5, S6, S7, like this. Next, hard work. Hard work means H10 to H19, that is chromium type. Ama. Next one is the high speed steels. These are very, very important. High speed steels. Okay, that is shown by, indicated by M and T. Okay, molybdenum type. Okay, next one is the tungsten type. Ama. Okay, this is all are tool steels. Okay, na. Next one is the same. These tools, the applications, how much percentage that elements are added. That means alloying added to this steel sama. Okay, na M1, A2, D2, O1, S1, W1. Okay, these are all are okay. Na the designations. Okay, specific types. suppose if you take M1, that is a used application, drills, SAS, lathe, and planner tools. Okay. Next one is the A2. A2 is the enana punches, embossing dies. Okay. These are the percentages of carbon percentage is 0.85. M1. A2 is 1. Next D2 is 1.2. That is okay. These all are the classifications of steels, that is tool steels, a designation, composition, application of six tools that are, you see, carbon, that is briefly the end of the bottle. See here. See, carbon steels, tool steels. Next one is the alloy steels. These three. Hello. Sir. Chandra sir. Chandra sir. Sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Sir. Good morning. Good morning.
Okay, sir.
Sir, sir, okay, do you want to take attendance? Attendance, sir.
Yeah, I will take, sir. I will take.
Okay, take it, sir. First. Okay.
I will take, sir.
Okay, okay. See here, carbon steels, Nana. The carbon steels are manufactured by cold finished and hot finished. That process, that is here, the application is the bars and plastic sheets and strip. Next one is the composition. Okay. The composition of this carbon steels is iron. Main iron percentage is more, that is the carbon, and next one is the manganese. That options are, then if you want, you can add, that is the, you see, sulfur and phosphorus is there. Okay, this is the microstructure of carbon steels. Okay, this one is the hard. Actually, this carbon steels are hard. Particularly hard, that means Martin's static structure. If it is soft, there is that is ferrite and plus that is a perlite, that combination. Okay, that is there. Next one is the alloy steels. Okay, that is hot finished. The alloy steels can be hot finished here. That is the, it can be converted bars and some plates. Here in alloy steels, that is the composition. That composition is iron plus, iron is more amount, that is the carbon. Carbon is how much percentage of carbon steels? Hello?
2%, sir.
Amma?
2%.
How much?
Sir.
Less than 2%. Okay, now that means 0 to 1.5. Okay. If it is maximum, that is the it goes to 2%. Okay. Most of the cases, that is 0 to just 1.5. Okay, na?
Okay, see, sir.
Okay. Here, that option, some of that adding elements. First is the composition is iron. Next one is the carbon. Next one is manganese. If you want to add a few elements, that is options are chromium, nickel, molybdenum, silicon, vanadium, that is sulfur, lead, aluminium. Okay. These all are the alloying elements, okay? By adding these elements to the steel, it is called alloying, okay? See, by adding these elements to the steel, then we will improve the properties of the, okay, the steel, that is the properties, mechanical properties, Okay, here, the nature is here, hard means that is the martensite, soft is that structure is the steel, okay? Here also, tool steels, and these are the important steels, yes, that are it can be art finished parts and forgings and a special that means quenching process, okay, and heat treatment processes. Next one is here, that is composition is only iron and carbon. Okay, iron and carbon. The carbon percentage, I hope, more in tool steels. Why? Because then you will use this tool steels for manufacture of tools, some cutting tools. Okay, na. That's why then the carbon percentage is more in this type of steels. That is the options. The alloying elements are chromium, nickel, molybdenum, manganese, silicon, that is a tungsten, cobalt, sulfur, vanadium, next aluminium. These all are the, that is the adding elements, that is the structure is hard. If it is hard, that is martensite plus alloy carbide. Soft is ferrite plus carbide, carbide perlite in W series. Okay, these are the microstructures. Okay, microstructures here. I think see that the hardness karu sama HRC this tool sama. Okay, carbon steels, alloy steels. Next one is the tool steels. Next one is the abrasion resistance. Next here hardness. Okay, hardness. Thing is, you know, carbon steels and okay, alloy steels and tool steels, how the hardness is varying, the temperatures. Okay, the temperatures, I think we are seeing here. Next one is wear. Abrasion means wear volume and time. The time is increases automatically, materials undergoes some corrosion. Okay, na, then wear will be occurred. Okay, like this here, that graphs are there. Here microstructures, that microstructures of the different steels are there. See, microstructure means, I hope already in first unit that you know, here grains are there, different types of grains, that is the fine grains and some hard coarse grains are there. Okay, grains. I think we have seen here stainless steels. Now stainless steels are very very important. Hello Chandra sir. Hello
sir
what sir?
Someone unmuted sir, someone. Okay sir, no problem. Sir, you are clear, audible sir.
Okay, there is no disturbance.
No disturbance.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Have you taken that attendance, sir?
Sir, I will take, sir. After some time, I ask them to raise their hands.
Okay, sir.
After
that,
I will take, sir.
Okay, nice, sir. Nice. Okay, sir. See, next one is the stainless steel, sir. Stainless steels are very, very important. See, if you see the stainless steels, the very very important characteristic of stainless steel is more resistant to rusting, and that means corrosion resistance. Amma, the stainless steels have corrosion resistance. Okay, then more resistant to rusting and staining than carbon and low alloy steels, stainless steels, sir. Next one is the in stainless steels, mainly that adding element is chromium. Amma, chromium, the chromium addition is will add particularly in stainless steels. Usually how much amount is above 10% weight. Amma, 10%. Okay, that is the chromium percentage in stainless steels. Okay, here see mainly four groups of the stainless steels are there. Four groups of stainless steels, that is the austenitic. Nana, see all of you, these names are very very important. Austenitic. Okay, na, austenitic stainless steels. Okay, austenitic stainless steel, that main that crystal structure is austenite, that is the FCC, is stabilized by adding nickel elements, etc. Okay, next one is the ferritic stainless steels. Ferritic stainless steels, here I hope you are seeing. Okay, without the high nickel content, then the stainless steels, then you will use that is the structure of crystal structure is PCC structure is stable at room temperature. Okay, stable at room temperature. Next one is the martensitic stainless steels. Hello, see martensitic stainless steel is the very very hard. That is the steels. These are this structure is the BCT body centered tetragonal structure at room temperature. Next precipitation hardening stainless steels. Okay, these are the stainless steels. Next one is Anna here stainless steels. Okay, that application I think then we may see here Anna that composition. Okay, the composition of stainless steels. I hope you are. I think you may see it may be visible here. Anna first one is a ferritic tick stainless steels. That condition is the annealed. Annealed means that is one of the heat treatment condition. Okay, next unit I will discuss that one. Okay, here the composition of ferritic tick stainless steel is 0.08% carbon. Carbon is very very less percentage. See, next one is the 11%. See all of you, 11% is the chromium, 1% is manganese, 0.5% is nickel, 0.7% is titanium. Okay, these all are the okay na the percentage composition of ferritic. The condition is the annealed condition. Okay, next one is here the tensile strength is see here 380, yield strength is 205, the ductility. This three are mechanical properties. I hope that has been studied in strength of material MOS subject. Here applications of the ferritic steel is automotive exhaust components, tanks for agriculture sprays. That is these applications. Next one is the in ferritic tick another composition is there. The composition is in this one is the chromium is the more compared to previous one. In previous one is the 11% chromium. Here is carbon percentage less, but more compared to that one. 0.2% is carbon. Next one is the chromium is the 25% is the chromium, 1.5% is magnesium. Condition also that is the annealed condition. Here you see the tensile strength and yield strength are more than previous one. Here see all of you. Okay, ductility is the same. Next one is where will you use this second ferritic steel composition? This one that is the high temperature applications. This one is valves high temperature applications. That is glass molds and combustion chambers. Okay. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Are you able to understanding, Nana? Hey, Babu.
Sir. Yes, sir.
See, next one is the austenitic stainless steels, Nana. Austenitic. Okay, na. Here, see, in austenitic, the composition of austenitic steel is see 0.08% carbon. Next one is the 9%. See. 19% is the chromium. Okay, 19% is the chromium. 9% is the nickel. Next one is the 2% is the manganese. That is the condition is annealed condition. Here the tensile properties, that is the tensile strength 515 205, yes, that is a 40% is that is ductility. Okay, here that applications of this that is, you know, what steel? This one austenitic. Austenitic steel is that is a chemical and a food processing equipment, cryogenic vessels. This one is okay. This austenitic steel, stainless steels. Next second composition also there. That is here varying the composition, particularly in austenitic stainless steels. That is. Carbon percentage is decreased. That is the 0.03. Next is this one also somewhat less than previous one. That is 17% chromium, 12% nickel is more in this one. 2.5% is the molybdenum, 2% manganese. This annealed condition, that is tensile properties, that is mechanical property, tensile strength, yield strength, and ductility. Yes, particularly this one is the used for welding constructions. Okay, welding constructions will use this steel, sir. Next one is martensitic stainless steel. In martensitic stainless steel, that composition is, see all of you here, I think martensitic is, first one is 0.15, that is the carbon, 12.5% is the chromium. Next one is the 1% is manganese, yes, annealed condition. And here martensitic is more, that is hard, very very hard, this material. That's why your tensile that is strength, yield strength are more. But the thing is, you know, here ductility is very less in this one. That is the applications is the rifle barrels and cluttery. The next one is jet engine parts. Okay, na, that is the martensitic. Next one is also martensitic second classification also there. Here also some composition is varied, okay, na. That is the 17% is chromium is there. Okay, here the tensile properties, that is the applications, surgical tools and bearings, cluttery. Okay, next one is the precipitation hardenable. Okay, here also that percentage is composition is there. This one is a precipitation hardened. Okay, here that is the tensile properties are more, particularly in this one. This one is the springs applications, is the springs, knives and pressure vessels. These all are the applications of that stainless steels and compositions. Okay, now that is the mechanical properties. Okay, that is the phase diagram. Here that percentage of chromium and nickel and everything. Okay, na. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Amma, have you understood?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, Nana. Here, see steels. Again, just I'm revising here. Steels. Nana, steels. See, low alloy, high alloy. Okay. Low alloy steel is the low carbon steels. Next, medium carbon, high carbon. Already, this one is discussed. Okay. This one is the low carbon steels. The carbon percentage is less than 0.25. Okay, see all of you. Medium carbon, the carbon percentage is 0.25 to 0.6% is the carbon. In the high carbon steels, the carbon percentage is 0.6 to that is 1.4%. These are the carbon percentages in low alloy steels. Next one is the high alloy steels. Just this ILI steel is already just so far I have discussed, that is stainless steels, Nana. Stainless steels. Okay, next tool steels here that are there. Next one is the low alloy steel is the plain. Okay, plain I steel, low alloy. Okay, that the classifications are there. Okay, and these are the increasing strength and cost. Decreasing ductility, that is the important factor. That is here the stainless steels are very high corrosion resistant. Okay, here ferrous alloys. Okay, ferrous alloys here, that is designations are given here. Normal nature. Okay, that is the 10 series, 11 series and 15 series. Okay, like this. Okay, and that percentages corresponding has given. In stainless steels, suppose all of you remember one thing, Nana, stainless steels, that the carbon, that the chromium percentage is more than how much stainless steels? Hello?
Sir.
Stainless is that the chromium percentage is more than?
More than 11%,
yes. How can you define the stainless steel is? The see, if you add that is chromium more than 11% to the steels, that steels are called stainless steels, chromium. Okay,
Okay, sir.
Okay, Nana. Okay, here different series, 10 series, 11 series, 15, 40 series like this is mentioned here. Suppose where XX is the weight, percentage of carbon, percentage of carbon into 100. See, so example, 1060 steel. Okay, plain carbon steel weight. See how much percentage of that is carbon is 0.6, 0.6. Okay, just all of you understand this. Okay, next one is the Nana. So far we have discussed about steels. Okay, next one is hello.
Cast iron, sir.
Cast iron. Okay. See, cast iron. See, what is the percentage of carbon in cast iron? Can you tell? Hey, Nana. Can you tell what is the percentage of
2.1
hello, the carbon percentage in cast iron is more than 2 amma. Okay, more than 2.
More than 2.
See, in iron carbon diagram, the carbon percentage is the 2 to 6.67 particularly. Okay, na, carbon percentage is here. In cast iron, that is, you will use commonly, that is 3 to 4.5 percentage of carbon. Okay, na? 3 to 4.5 percentage of carbon in cast iron. Okay, see, this cast iron's property is low melting point. These are the brittle, brittle materials and easy to cast, easiest to cast. Okay, na? Yes. Here, cementite decomposes to, that is a ferrite plus graphite. Then how can you get, Emma, this cast iron is that chemical reaction is given here, that is Fe3C, that is a cementite decomposes to ferrite plus graphite, that is the 3Fe plus C, that is the graphite, okay, no, that is carbon. See, cementite Fe3C is a metastable phase graphite formation promoted by C, that is the adding of that is silica, and next one more than 1%, that is next one is a slow cooling. Okay, see here iron carbon diagram. I hope then you will see here, that is the graphite formation prompted by, that is, see, adding, that is silica, more than 1%. Here, what are the types of cast irons are there. Here, total, that the cast irons are mainly 4 types. The fifth one is, okay, then we will discuss. Not some more discussion. Yes, only very less. This fourth one, fifth one is the not much more significant. Only the mainly commonly you will discuss four. That is four types of cast irons are there. That is, first one is the gray cast iron. Next one is, second one is the noodler or ductile cast iron. Third one is the white cast iron. Fourth one is the malleable cast iron. Fifth one is the compacted graphite cast iron. These 5 types, okay, are, we will discuss the first four are important. Okay. Hello.
Okay. Hello. Sir.
Emma. See, is it audible? Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nama. Just all of you be attentive. Okay, na. See, okay, the cast irons are very, very important in our syllabus. That is subject, and at the same time in our daily life also. Okay, na. The applications and very, very important. See, then I'm going to discuss about one by one. that cash terms nana
see all of you here
first one is the gray cast iron gray iron is written here okay gray cast iron okay yes see first one is the that percentage is carbon is 2.5 to 4%. Next one is the silica is 1 to 3% amma in gray cast iron. Here that the structure of gray cast iron, see nana, flakes are there. See the first one is that this black, that is the flakes first, okay na, that is the structure graphite flakes plus ferrite and cementite, okay, that is ferrite and sorry ferrite and perlite, okay. Here brittleness brittleness property is due to the flake like graphite like this some that forms that flakes some, okay. Here this one is the weak and brittle under tension, strong under compression, okay. The property of this cast iron, gray cast iron, is the weak. Where it is weak, where this one is weak and brittle under tension, in tensile condition, that is if you apply the tensile force, that is weak in tensile condition particularly, okay. Here stronger under compression. Compression means, okay, all of you well known this one, the compression, compressive load, okay. When you apply the compressive load, it this one it can be easily withstand that compressive load, amma. That is the tensile load, it can be easily, okay, fail in tensile condition, okay. Next one is that property is nana, here excellent vibrational damping capacity, okay. See excellent vibrational damping capacity. See what is damping, vibrational vibrations means, okay na, suppose when you apply any load, that vibrations, suppose if rail is moving on the moving on the road means on the rail sama, okay na, then what will happen, some vibrations will be formed, okay na, that vibrations, okay. The cast iron, if you use this material, it will withstand that vibration, okay na, vibrations, yes, that is it has excellent vibrational damping means to resist that vibrations, okay, vibrational damping, okay, capacity amma. Next one is the wear resistant. Wear, what is wear? Love, hello
sir,
wear resistant, wear resistant
அரிபாடா சார்
ஆ எஸ் தட் இஸ் வேரிங் மீன்ஸ் தட் இஸ் த ஓகே வேரிங் மீன்ஸ் வேர் அண்ட் டியர் யுவர்
எஸ் சார் இட்
இஸ் நவ அண்ட் தென் இயரிங் தட் இஸ் அர்குதல அர்குதல அண்டர் ஓகேனா தட் இஸ் வேர் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் அம்மா ஓகேனா தட் இஸ் த யூ see decreasing in size ஓகே decreasing in size ஓகேனா தட் இஸ் வேர் அம்மா ஓகேனா தட் இஸ் done by the time, okay na, that wears and tears, okay na, that is it has good wear resistant, okay, material am this one. Next one is the ductile, okay, ductile or nodular cast iron, nodular, see some like dots, that is ductile cast iron or nodular. Small amount, that is, you know, okay na, small amount of magnesium and next one is the cesium is there, yes. Next one is the sphereoidal, graphite precipitates, that is noodles rather than flakes, spheroidal spheres, like spheres. Okay, here that structure is there. See all of you, this one is the noodler or ductile cast iron, spheroidal. Okay, now graphite precipitate noodles rather than flakes. Okay, next one is the matrix of in that is perlite and ferrite. Ductility increased by a factor of 20. The strength is doubled. Okay, particularly I hope this one is the okay soft soft one compared to gray cast iron. Okay, the structure is there like this. Okay. Gray cast iron, nama. Here the structure. This one is the TEMM, that is the transmission electron microscope microstructures. Okay, na. The microstructure of perlite in a gray cast iron. This one is optical microscope, but the microstructure of gray cast iron. See. Steels, nana steels, you know, A is the steel, see, vibrational dam, amplitude. See, here this one is the gray cast iron, that is, it is vibrating, vibrating, damping resistance, this one, it has the property. See, how the vibrations are spreading, see, low, steels.
Okay, sir, very low, sir.
Yes, in gray cast iron, that vibrational, vibrations are very low. Okay, na, it resists the vibrations. The gray cast iron. See all of you. Okay. Have you understood?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. See, next one is. Come on, next one is the white cast iron, and next one is the malleable cast irons are there. Okay. White and malleable cast irons. See here that. 1% that is less than 1% of silica, that is harder. This one is the harder and harder but brittle. Next in this one euctic carbide. Okay, na, this one it the euctic carbide plus perlite is there. Large amount of Fe3C formed during casting. Okay, cementite is formed in this one. That's why this one is the very, very hard. Okay, the cementite is formed in this one. That's why this one is white cast iron is very, very hard material. Okay, the structure is, I think it can be seen. Okay, next one is the malleable cast iron. The result of annealing, that is white cast iron, that is the casting. Yes, temperature is 800 degrees centigrade, 900 degrees centigrade, cementite. That is here graphite precipitates and clusters are roastily. Next one is a more ductile amma, this malleable cast irons. Okay, next one is here types of cast irons. Okay, that is the compacted graphite that the cast iron is there. See here that the microstructures of all cast irons. Okay, anyhow here that are applications, gray cast iron and ductile cast iron, malleable cast iron, this all the cast irons, that is applications are there. Okay, that is limitations, relatively high density and relatively low conductivity, poor corrosion resistance, that is okay. So for nana
sir.
Hello.
Sir.
These all are the nana steels and the cast irons. I hope all of you understand this steels and cast irons. Tomorrow class is there. Hello. Tomorrow first period is there. Okay, na.
Okay, sir.
Then I will discuss that steels and cast irons briefly tomorrow also. Next. After completing that one, I will start the non-ferrous alloys, that is aluminium, copper, titanium, few alloys. Then I will discuss tomorrow. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Then all of you prepare this ferrous and non-ferrous LIS, that the second unit, amma. This one is the second unit. Okay, just this total unit is the entirely theory. Yeah. Okay, na Yogendra.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Pawan. Entirely theory.
Yes, sir.
That's why.
Yes, sir.
Just unless and until you prepare, then you don't know anything. Yeah. Okay, na.
Okay, sir.
Understand.
Okay, sir.
Okay, just all of you prepare the subject, amma. Just how to remember all the matter, just frequently just to prepare and remember the types of steels classification and cast iron classification some. Okay na?
Yes sir.
Okay, do you have any doubts, then you can ask me, then definitely I will rectify your doubts. Emma, just I have sent one test book. Okay, then all of you see the test book and prepare. Okay, the matter, then I will send a few PPTs and PDFs also, then no problem, then all of you, okay na, prepare this subject, don't neglect. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay na, just I'm closing this session. Okay na, tomorrow then we'll start. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank
you, sir.
Okay, sir. Chandra sir. Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay.